Welcome to the M360 Privacy and Security event in The Hague. Set against a backdrop of the massive ransomware attack which hit a number of companies earlier this month, and a year ahead of the new EU data privacy regulation coming in, there was certainly a lot to talk about.
The Director General of the GSMA, Mats Granerud, gave an overview of how big a task the industry is facing.
The ubiquity of mobile services has created a new business model to emerge, where we see an increasing of productivity and efficiency for enterprises and individuals alike.
One of the most controversial issues was how to deal with the GDPR, the new EU data privacy rules coming in next year.
We are totally convinced that you can never be 100% compliant with the new GDPR. So we always say choose a data protection standard that suits your company profile. If you have a high risk profile, then you of course need a higher data protection standard than once you are, for instance, a B2B company with a very limited amount of personal data.
The idea is not to cripple business. The idea is to make businesses more accountable for the information that they hold. So with that in mind, you take what you can and you put in as much compliance as you as your business will allow.
You want to have happy customers. Customer wants to trust you. And if you can't provide this trusted environment to your customers, customers don't come. They go to somebody else.
You cannot have the cake and eat it. I mean, if people would like to have so-called free services, which are basically based on that you do not pay for them, you can then start, you know, blocking all the advertisement, I suppose, because then people will say, wait a second, I mean, I will block the service for you, and that's what's happening already. So, you know, people using ad blockers sometimes do not get access to the service anymore, and so on and so forth. So I think that people realize more and more that there is no free lunch and that basically things, of course, are paid based on their data.
We've spent 20 years not fixing the problem of identity on the internet, and we're about to make it 20 billion times worse by connecting everything else to the internet. So unless we come up with an industry infrastructural approach to this, we're literally building a Chernobyl. You know, we're building a system which is going to blow and is going to distribute people's personal data like radioactive waste across the landscape and render it utterly unusable.
Another prominent theme was how to deal with IoT, not just when it comes to data privacy, but also network security.
With IoT, security is obviously a big potential barrier. We're not going to see this utopia of billions and billions of connected devices unless these issues are resolved.
Not very many people realize, but today's attacks or malware campaigns, if you will, have very, very short lives. A typical phishing campaign takes less than 5 minutes. And so being able to react at high speeds, I would call superhuman speeds, is key these days. And so that's also where machine learning really helps.
I don't think there's going to be a one-size-fits-all approach to IoT security, and any framework needs to develop a set of criteria that'll differentiate between, you know, high-risk use cases with other types of use cases where the risk might be lower. The regulation needs proportionate to the risk associated with each device, but, you know, we certainly look forward to seeing the more detail of the Commission's proposals.
That wraps up our coverage of this year's event. One thing we've learned is that privacy and security are issues that are not going away anytime soon.
The one consensus, though, is that we need to be prepared for ever more sophisticated threats.